basag sa pamamagitan po ng ating mga mata ngayon. Samahan niyo po ako sa ating pagbabasa. After this, I looked, and there before me was a door standing open in heaven. And the voice that I had first heard speaking to me like a trumpet said, "Come up here, and I will show you what must take place after this." At once I was in the spirit, and there before me was a throne in heaven with someone sitting on it. And the one who sat there had the appearance of jasper and carnelian, a rainbow resembling an emerald encircled the throne. Surrounding the throne were 24 thrones, 24 other thrones, and seated on them were 24 elders. They were dressed in white and had crowns of gold on their heads. From the throne came flashes of lightning, rumblings, and peals of thunder. Before the throne, seven lamps were blazing. These are the seven spirits of God. In verse 6, also, before the throne, there was what looked like a sea of glass, clear as crystal. In the center around the throne were four living creatures, and they were covered with eyes in front and in back. The first living creature was like a lion. The second was like an ox. The third had a face like a man. And the fourth was like a flying eagle. Each of the four living creatures had six wings and was covered with eyes all around, even under his wings. Day and night, they never stopped saying, and they said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come." Whenever the living creatures give glory, honor, and thanks to him who sits on the throne and who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before him who sits on the throne and worship him who lives forever and ever. They lay their crowns before the throne and say, "You are worthy, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they were created and have their being." Bless the word of the Lord right now. Hallelujah. Tayo manalangin. Panginoon, marami pong salamat sa iyong banal na salita. Namin pong mapapakinggan at mapag-aaralan sa hapong ito. Before the throne in heaven, O Father, we are asking you to guide us. Sit beside us, O Holy Spirit. We need your power. We need your anointing at this moment. Help us to see the things that you wanted us to see. Help us to know your will in these words that we're going to study. Panginoon, marami po salamat. Buksan mo lahat ng aming kaisipan, ang aming puso. Tunay nga po, Panginoon, ito'y maging mataba sa pagtatanim ng iyong banal na salita. Tulungan mo na po kami na maintindihan po namin ang lahat ng sinasabi ng iyong banal na salita sa araw na ito. God, apart from you, we cannot do anything. Tulungan mo kami na mangyari lamang ang kalooban mo sa aming kalagitnaan. Even right now, Father God, as I deliver thy word, give me the courage and the boldness. God, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable unto your sight, for you are my redeemer and you are my strength. Father, abase your servant and let you alone be exalted. Let you alone be increased and your servant be decreased. Right now, in Jesus' name, I entrust to you everything, O Father God. Words are not enough to give you thanks. That's why, Panginoon, pinagkakatiwala po namin sa inyo ang lahat. Makapangyarihang Diyos, sa pamamagitan ng iyong banal na Espiritu Santo, samahan kami sa oras na ito, sapagkat narito ka sa aming kalagitnaan. We thank you, we bless you, and we give you all the praises, honor, thanksgiving, and all the people of God will say, Amen. Amen. Palakpakan po natin ang ating Panginoon Diyos. Hallelujah. Pag-aaralan po natin ngayon ang building a habitation for the Lord. Yan po ang ating talakayan sa hapong ito. So building a habitation for the Lord is our God. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng habitation? Habitation means a dwelling or a house. Habitation means the natural abode or locality of a plant or an animal. Habitation means a place where someone or something is usually found. It is scripture po. Matutunghayan po natin sa banal na salita ng ating Panginoong Diyos that habitation is translated to tabernacle. What is tabernacle? Tabernacle means God's dwelling place. It's a residence. Amen po ba?
Amen. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Bumalik po tayo sa ating pong text na ating pong pinag-aaralan ngayon. In the book of Revelation, we are invited into God's house. Paano po yun? Yan po sila, kung paano po sila lumalapit into the Holy of Holies, si Moses at si Joshua in the tabernacle. Praise God. Next. In the book of Revelation, we are invited into God's house. Tingnan po natin. Buksan po natin again ang Revelation chapter 4 from 1 to 2. Paano po ba tayo iniimbitahan ng ating Panginoon into His house? Tingnan po natin. According to verse 1 to 2, ang sabi po dito, "After this, I looked, and there before me was a door standing open." maging ang bilang ng ating mga buhok ay alam na alam ng Diyos. Everything are exposed in the sight of God. Saan lang po tayo magtago, naroon po siya. Kaya ang tanong, is God is sitting on the throne of our hearts? Amen? Nasaid niya po ba tayo? Because we ask Jesus to come into our hearts. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Everyone here are saved. Praise the Lord. Number two. Secondly, may kita po natin that John arrested by the fact that there is a continual chorus of holiness to the Lord around the throne. Tignan po natin ang verse 8. Ano po sinasabi ng verse 8? Sabi po rito, each of the four living creatures had six wings and was covered with eyes all around. Even under his wings, ano sabi? Day and night, they were never stop saying, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty who was and is to come. Ngayon, ang sabi dito, it isn't something they do it at a certain time. They're not just only holy during Sundays between 2 to 5 p.m., but when they are with a particular group, they're not just only holy, but they are holy continually. Ano sabi? Day and night, they are holy. Amen? Question, are we holy day and night? Nasagot po ba natin yan? Are we holy day and night? What about when nobody else is looking? What about when nobody else is around? What things do we watch? What things do we listen? What things do we read? And what things do we participate in? Can we honestly say that day and night we are holy? Hello? Or we're just always only holy during Sunday. But the Bible says, the 24 elders, they are holy. Day and night, they continually having a continual chorus of holiness, singing, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Amen. Now, if we are going to prepare a habitation for God, God wants our heart to be holy. Amen. Ngayon ang tanong, ano bang ibig sabihin ng holiness? Holiness, kita kailangan ba? Kapag tayo po at laging ay lumalakad ng merong kabanalan? Amen. Kailangan po bilang isang Kristiyano. Sabi po rito, holiness is walking into the character and the statues of the living God. Because our primary goal, our primary function as believers is to behold His beauty until it permits every avenue of our life. Amen. Isaiah said that the people of God will be called the holy people. Sabi po ni Isaiah, kinakailangan tawag sa atin is holy people. Holy people, the redeemed of the Lord, which is a city called sought out. Amen. We are all sold out to Jesus. We are all a holy nation, a peculiar people. That out of darkness, He brought us into His marvelous light. That is holiness. Walking into the character and into the statues of the living God. In this generation, we must pursue the knowledge of holiness. And what is that? We have not been a people preconditioned to leading holy lives, but we must walk into the holiness according to the character of God. Amen. Because Paul told also that perfect holiness is in the fear of God. Alam niyo po, kapag wala ng fear of God ang isang tao, hindi na po siya umaayon sa kabanalan ng ating Panginoong Diyos. Are you with me? That's why perfect holiness is in the fear of
Amen.
That's why Chronicles 16:29, ano po sinasabi doon? Tutitignan niyo po sa inyo po mga Biblia. 2 Chronicles 16:29, ascribe to the Lord the glory that is due in His name.
Hallelujah.
At kung sabi, bring an offering and come before Him. That's why when we are bringing our offering to the altar of God, that is holy to Him. Amen?
Amen.
Our lives. Ano po ba yung character qualities na sinasabi?